Hey guys, welcome back to the channel and thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you don't know me, I make videos on finance, investing, and business. And in this one, we're going to be walking through Rivian's IPO. So if you like my content, please consider liking and subscribing as it really helps with the YouTube algorithm. So without further ado, let's hop right into the video. What is Rivian and why is it so popular? So Rivian Automotive was founded by 36-year-old Robert Scaringe and is coming up fast behind Tesla. Largely unknown outside of automotive circles, the privately held maker of SUVs and pickup trucks has yet to sell a vehicle, but Scaringe nonetheless has raised major funding from some of the most respected names in corporate America, a total of $1.7 billion, including $700 million from Amazon and $500 million from Ford Motor Company. So let's take a look at the article. EV maker Rivian files for initial public offering. So electric vehicle maker Rivian Automotive has filed the S-1 for its initial public offering. The company cites a placeholder amount of $100 million to be updated later. It's filing through a large syndicate led by Morgan Stanley, Goldman Sachs, and JP Morgan. But the company, backed by Amazon and Ford, is looking to raise up to $8 billion, which would mean a valuation of $80 billion, and an $8 billion raise would be the fourth biggest in the US over the past decade. It's looking to list on the Nasdaq Global Select Market under the symbol RIVN. For the 6 months ended June 30th, the company notes to spend $990 million in operating costs, $683 million in research and development, and $307 million in selling, general, and administrative costs to lead a net loss of $994 million. As competition, it cites those representing the millions of traditional internal combustion engine vehicles and EVs sold each year in the consumer and commercial markets. Our competitive set also represents our TAM, which we can reach with an extended product portfolio over the long term in our current and future geographies. But as it works across the value chain, competition extends beyond OEMs or dealers. Downstream, competitors include a patchwork of third parties, including charging providers, vehicle service providers, vehicle remarketers, and traditional fleet management companies. Let me know down below if you think Rivian's going to be a successful company and if you're going to buy it during its IPO. Well, that's all I've got for today. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. Make sure to hit the like button to help out with the YouTube algorithm. Also, make sure to subscribe to keep up with all my uploads. Quick reminder to check the description below for additional resources related to finance, investing, and YouTube. Enough said, have a great day, and thanks for watching and stopping by. I'll see you in the next one.